Hello friends, this is Priyanka. Today we are going to understand basic concepts for the kinematic chain in the chapter Simple Mechanism. We are going to understand this concept with the help of diagram and we are also going to solve some problems related to this. Now let us first understand how we can define the kinematic chain. So it is a combination of kinematic pairs joined in such a way that each link forms a part of two pairs and relative motion in between links is completely constrained or successfully constrained. Now if we observe this definition, we will first understand what is link and what is pair. Now I will draw here link AB and link CD. So this is the AB, so this is the link AB and here is the link CD. So I will say here this is also the link. Now if these two links are getting connected with one point, then this point of connection is known as pair. So now we will better understand what is link and what is pair. Now for this kinematic chain there are particular conditions that are getting applied related to link and pair. So we will understand that condition. Now this pair is shown here as a kinematic pair. So how we can say or when we can say that this pair is kinematic pair? So when the motion in between pairs is completely constrained or successfully constrained, then these pairs are known as the kinematic pairs. So now we will understand what is the completely constrained motion and it is also called as successfully constrained motion. So here completely constrained motion is the motion between pair is limited to definite direction irrespective of the direction of applied force. Now we will understand this concept with the help of diagram. And in this diagram, there are the four links that are getting attached with each other and how the motion is completely constrained motion. That is also we will understand with the help of this diagram. Now, in this diagram, we will first understand how many pairs are there. So that is, we know that pair is the point of connection of the two links. So we will also understand how many links are also there. So now, in the diagram, crankshaft is connected with bearing. So at that point where the crankshaft is connected with bearing, that is the point A and that is also known as the pair A. Then the next is connecting rod with crank. So connecting rod is attached to the crank at point B. So here pair is at point B. Then piston with connecting rod. So piston with connecting rod is attached at point C. So we will say that it is the point C is the pair. And then piston with cylinder. So piston with cylinder is getting attached with the point D. So we will say that point C is the D is also pair. Now what is the relation in between this piston with cylinder? So piston with cylinder is the sliding motion. So now if we observe this diagram, these are the four pairs, that is A, B, C and D. Now we will move for the links. How many links are there? That is link AB is there, BC is there, CD is there and DA is there. Now the link D to A is the fixed link. So what is happening for the fixed link? So because of this link DA is fixed link, then the motion in between the other pairs, that is pair BC and this D, is limited to a definite direction. So if we observe this link CD is getting motion, or this pair link CD is the combination of two pairs, that is the pair C and pair D. So it is having only horizontal motion. Then now if we observe the pair B. So this pair B is having motion, rotary motion. So that is fixed. And it is irrespective of the applied force. So we can say that it is completely constrained motion. Now what is the second condition? Second condition is that each link forms a part of two pairs. Now we will understand is this condition satisfied or not. So we will move for link AB. So this link AB is the part of two pairs, part of pair A and pair B. Then link BC, it is also part of two pairs, pair B and pair C. Then link CD, it is the part of also two pairs, pair C and pair D. And then link DA, it is also part of two pairs, that is pair A and pair D. So we can say that this satisfies all the conditions that are getting included in this kinematic chain. Now again there is one relation or there is one equation for the number of links and number of pairs. If this equation is also getting satisfied, then we can say that that chain or combination of this kinematic pair is the kinematic chain. So we have to decide. Now what is that equation? So that equation is L is equal to 2P minus 4. So here there are number of links 4, which is equal to 2 into number of pairs A, B, C, D, that is 4 minus 4. So if we solve this, we will get 4 is equal to 4, that is left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we can say that all the pairs in this diagram are the kinematic pairs, and the combination of these pairs is known as kinematic chain. Now again there is the relation in between joints and link. So again there are 4 number of joints, that is A, B, C and D, and links are also 4. So again I will solve this. J is equal to, therefore 4 is equal to 3 by 2 into 4 minus 2, which is equal to 6 minus 2, which is equal to 4. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So these two conditions are getting satisfied with this kinematic chain or these kinematic pairs. So we have to cross verify each mechanism given in the question with these two equations. Now we will understand the given combination of link and pair is the kinematic chain or not, with the help of two equations. So this is the first equation, which is in between link and pairs, and this is the second equation, which is in between joints and links. So now we will take the first example. Now here this is the link AB, link BC and link AC. That means there are total number of links is equal to 3. Then how many number of pairs are there? That is the point of connection of two links, that is A, B, C. So number of pairs is equal to 3 and number of joints is also equal to 3. Now if we put here the values in the equation number first, that is L is equal to 3 is equal to 2 into 3 minus 4. So if we solve this 3, and on the right hand side it is 2, that means LHS is greater than RHS. Now we will move for the second. Now here is also joints, so there are 3 number of joints, which is equal to 3 by 2 into 3 minus 2. So if we solve this, 3 is equal to 4.5 minus 2, that is equal to 2.5. That is, here is also LHS is greater than RHS. That is, for equation number 1 and equation number 2, left hand side is greater than right hand side. So we can say that there is no any relative motion in between the pairs is possible, and that's why this chain is called as locked chain. And there is no any motion that is possible, so we can say this is the rigid structure. Now again we will move for the next combination. So if we observe, here is the link AB, BC, link CD and link DA. So how many number of links? That are 4. Then how many number of pairs? That are also 4. And how many number of joints? That are equal. That is also equal to 4. Now I will put the value in equation number 1. So 4 is equal to 2 into P. That is 2 into 4. 8 minus 4. So therefore 4 is equal to 4. So I will say that LHS is equal to RHS. Then again joints. So number of joints are 4 is equal to 3 by 2 into L. That is 4 minus 2. So 4 is equal to 4. So again LHS is equal to RHS. So now these two equations are getting satisfied. Now in this mechanism we will understand how the motion is the completely constrained motion. Now in this there are total number of links are 4. So suppose the link AB is getting fixed and there is a definite displacement for this link AD. So I will draw here, or I will show here, here is the angle theta where this link AD is getting displaced. Then these two links, link CD and link BC, are also having some definite displacement. That means we can say that this is the motion of the links is completely constrained. So we can say that this is the kinematic chain. Now we will move for the next. So for here we will again observe how many links are there. So AB, BC, CD, DE and EA. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are total number of links, that is 5. Then pairs. So it is the combination of two links, that is A, B, C, D, E. So number of pairs is equal to 5 and number of joints, that is also equal to 5. Now we will put the value in the equation. So L is equal to 2P minus 4. So L is equal to 5, which is equal to 2 into 5, that is 10 minus 4. Therefore 5 is equal to 6. So we can say that LHS is less than RHS. Now again we will move for the equation number 2. So joints. So joints are also 5 is equal to 3 by 2 into L. 5 minus 2. If we solve this, 7.5 minus 2, that is 5 is equal to, right hand side is 5.5. So we can say that LHS is less than RHS. So there is left hand side is not equal to right hand side. So we can conclude that this is not the kinematic chain. And if left hand side is less than right hand side, then we can say that this is the unconstrained chain. And this chain is not for the practical use. Now we will again move for the next combination. So here in this combination we have to decide how many number of links are there, how many number of joints and how many number of pairs are there. So I will mention here, so number of links. So L is equal to, now if we observe here is the link AD and here this is the link AE, and in between this link AE there is just here is the point B. Because if we observe this AB and B having no any relative motion in between them, that's why we will consider this AE as a one link. So I will mention here is the link AE, then EF, then FG. If we observe now this BG and GC, these two, if we consider these two links, then they are having no any relative motion in between them. That's why we will consider this is the one link, that is BC. Then CD and AD. So how many number of links are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the same way, now we will observe how many number of pairs are there. Now pairs is the point of connection of the two links. and they are having relative motion in between the links. Now if we observe, here is the point A. So this point A is the connection of the link AE and link AD. So this link AE and link AD having relative motion about this point A. Then point D for link AD and DC. Then point C. So point C is for CD and CB. Then point E. So point E for AE and EF and point F. That is for EF and this link GF. Now if we observe, there are how many number of pairs are there? That is, there are number of pairs is equal to 5. Now again we will move for the joint. So joint means the point of connection. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So number of joints are. So if I will mention here, I will mention A, B, C, D, E, F and G. So which is equal to 7. So now from this we can understand clearly. Now there are two equations, so we have to define it, this equation whether satisfies or not. So now I will take here link, which is equal to 6, 2 into P, that is 5 minus 4. So 6 is equal to 10 minus 4, that is 6. So LHS is equal to RHS. Now we will move for the next, that is joint. So number of joints are 7 is equal to 3 by 2 into 6 minus 2. That is here 7 is equal to 7, that is LHS is equal to RHS. So these two conditions are getting satisfied. Now we will decide about the motion. So whether it is completely constrained motion or not. So in this diagram, suppose this link AE is getting fixed, then the displacement of any link, that is link AD or the link BC or link EF, through a angle theta, then all the other links are getting displaced in a definite direction. So we can say that this motion is completely constrained motion or successfully constrained motion. So here we can say that this combination of link forms a kinematic chain.